Hello and welcome. Today we're going to do an inflate and deflate video on my wife's FJ Cruiser. She has 35 inch tires and we're going to go from 35 to 15 and back up again many times. We're going to use these adjustable deflators that you can get on Amazon for cheap. They're like $16 for six of them. We'll try those. We have these rapid deflators that you can actually test the pressure while they're on deflating, but they'll go to zero. So you got to be very careful with these. And we're going to use the multi-deflator, which is what this video is really all about, how that works. To inflate, we're going to do the opposite. We're going to do a multi-inflator with using this guy, and then we're going to do a single inflation one tire at a time using the Smittybilt or the Maxi Trac, the brand new one. So without further ado, we'll get this going. We're going to set a timer for each. We'll set this timer on deflating and inflating, and we'll see how it goes. Here it goes with the auto adjusters. I'll hit the timer. So part of the auto deflator is you have to check them once in a while because they're set to about 15, 16, but they don't vary, or they vary quite a bit. So just gotta watch them. Sometimes they go past your target of 15 PSI. So one of these you have to pull off and see where it's at, just be sure it's on track. We'll see. These are nice because you don't have to think about what you're doing with them. You just let them do their thing. But they work by spring compression, and as they get closer and lower, it blocks off the hole more and more. So when they get closer to the target, they slow down. They actually get slower as time goes on, and from the lower pressure as well. So that's one thing that's nice about them. You can kind of tell when they're getting towards the end, but you're always kind of guessing. You're not really sure what they are. You can't check them without pulling them off first, which is what I'm doing now. Six minutes, 6 seconds, and it was at 15 PSI, coming down from 35. Now we're gonna use the rapid deflators. These are not set, they just will go to zero, but you can check them while they're deflating, and I'll show you that in a second, how that exactly works. Here we go. So all four are on right now, and I gotta keep eye on them to go to zero, like I said. But they're all very much faster than the auto-adjusting deflators, the ones that are set point. So I gotta keep eyeing them, that's what I'm gonna do now. These are tricky. I try to put the fast ones in order, the fast one on first, as opposed to last. Otherwise, what will happen is that you put the last one on, it'll be lower than your first one, if you understand what I'm saying. It's all confusing, but you want them in order, fastest to slowest, otherwise it causes problems. Four minutes and 53 seconds with the rapid deflators. Okay, now we're gonna deflate with the multi-tire deflator. Here we go. So all four tires are hooked up to this now, are deflating at the same time. You can see the pressure by just looking at the gauge. It says 26.0. It doesn't read when you're deflating, but as soon as you stop it, it will read it again. 25.5. 4 minutes, 9 seconds, right at 15.0. All four tires are balanced because they're all connected together. So, all right, now we're going to inflate using the Smittybilt, using one tire at a time. So here we go. On It's like 11 and a half minutes almost to complete that job. One tire at a time with the Smittybilt. I got lucky on one tire. It was right on when I pulled it off. So three of them I had to adjust back down to move over. But 11 and a half minutes. Okay, this time we're going to inflate the tires using the Maxi Trac, one tire at a time. Here we go. Seven minutes, 58 seconds. That's with the Maxi Trac, off-road wheels. Now we're using Maxi Trac with the multi-inflator off-road wheels at the same time. Here we go.
Before we see that last result, let's do a quick review. But first, please like and subscribe. When we were doing the deflation test, the first thing we started out was the auto set deflator. It's the one that you actually set the set point and you put it on and you can kind of forget about it. Or do you? I like to trust them a little bit, but sometimes they can go far beyond and I've actually had to go past. So what you end up doing is you end up putting them higher above your set point. Let's say, for example, 15 PSI. I probably put this around 16, that way if there's an error or 17, it's not gonna go below 15. Anyway, that time was 6 minutes and 6 seconds. The next one we did was the rapid deflate, which is the one you can put on and check at the same time, a little bit faster at 4 minutes and 53 seconds. Both of these require many checks as they go down, like I was mentioning. The auto set actually slows at the end, which kind of tells you it's getting close, but it gets slower. This one is faster, about a minute faster, but it can actually just go to zero. And you gotta be really careful because you can easily go past your 15 PSI checkpoint. And you're checking them a lot. This is actually to remove the first one. Also, you have to remove the check with, you know, something that you trust, a PSI gauge. Well, the rapid ones, you can actually check while it's on. That's a little bit faster. So it's about a minute faster overall. High effort, running around, checking the tire many times. You saw it in the video. So the next one is the multi-inflate, which is all four tires at the same time. I took the hoses off so you can see it. But this came in a time of 4 minutes and 9 seconds. Look, about a minute faster, I would say, is rapid because we're doing all four tires at the same time. But the biggest thing is that you basically gotta check each tire twice. I mean, once it's hooked up, all four tires together, you just turn it off. Remember, you know, to check it and turn it back on to have airflow, turn off to check it. Very simple. It's right there. You don't shoot past your point. You can see it easily. All you do is flip a switch on and off to check it. You don't have to pull off whatever's on there, put the gauge on there and switch back or what have you. Much, much easier. So the effort is definitely much low on this guy. Definitely higher on these by far. Even though the times might be, you know, 2 minutes is not a big deal. Effort is a huge deal. On the other side, when we started inflating, we had the Smittybilt doing one tire at a time, we had the Maxi Trac one tire at a time, and then the purpose of this whole analysis was using the multi-inflate with the Maxi Trac and compare the two, three, these two, and then all three together. The Smittybilt came in at 11:29, kind of along. The Maxi Trac came in much faster at 7 minutes and 58 seconds. One thing to note on both of these, because you're doing one tire at a time, again, many different checks. You put it on, you have to check it, take it off. And one note on both of these is the modified chuck. I did use a quick disconnect, which is something that doesn't come standard on it. I got this pretty cheap and expensive. You just clip it on, you can clip it off. It saves you much time. The screw-on one that comes with it, even more difficult because now you have to unscrew it just to check the pressure and screw it back on. I don't trust this gauge here. I mean, you can turn off the pump and read the gauge. It's not a good gauge. It has a different reading when you're increasing or you're adding air to it. It's usually about 45 PSI before it's actually at 35. And then as the pump warms up and this warms up, it ends up being about 48. It's very inaccurate. So I always like to use something I trust, which is a separate calibrated type meter, pressure gauge. This one is not nearly as good, but that chuck saves you much, much time when you're doing one tire at a time. That's a special note. And that's kind of the best case scenario, I'd say. If I had the normal screw-in one, it'd be way longer, probably about 2 or 3 minutes. And the effort would be even more. So both these work by one method where you have to go up above your target of 35 PSI, and then you use something to come back down, something you trust. So it's like a more effort to actually go back and then let air out type of deal. So both these are definitely higher effort because of that. Many checks to each tire, each and every time, running around, moving it from one tire to the next, running back to the previous one, etc. Much, much different than the last one. And for the time, it's much faster as well. What is it? The Maxi Trac with the multiflate. End up coming in at 4 minutes and 52 seconds. Much, much faster. You can see almost 3 minutes faster than one tire at a time, which is quite significant. But the big thing is the effort. Again, you check them all for at the same time. All you have to do is flip the switch, and you know exactly what the pressure is, and you can turn it back on or turn it back on, let more air in for the switch to check it. So much easier. It's a digital gauge. You can trust it. It's caught off from the pump. It's so much easier. And it only requires 2 trips to each tire. Put it on, pull it off. That's it. Low effort. Low effort. Extremely. And that's what really this is all about. So the conclusion is the multiflate is not only faster, as we can see, it's also easier. How much faster? Well, if you look at these numbers, it's about 1.6 times faster, or about 61% just by using this tool. It's awesome. Thanks for watching.